This video describes the architecture of Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, so you can better understand how Microsoft delivers this service to customers. Built on the Microsoft Azure Cloud, every customer gets a dedicated Microsoft Defender for Endpoint tenant, each isolated from every other tenant. Of course, that means customers' data is isolated and secured within their tenants. That data is only accessible by customers through Azure Active Directory authentication, and access is audited. Within each tenant is a rich Behavioral Indicators of Attack, or IOA, dictionary. This includes heuristics, behavioral rules, machine learning, and anomaly detection algorithms that detect suspicious, attack-related events in the sensor data. Further, Microsoft Defender for Endpoint uses big data, machine learning, our unique optics into the Windows ecosystem, and the threat landscape to translate behavioral signals into actionable insight, detections, and recommended actions. And when turned on, our built-in automation runs when the service generates alerts, starting automated threat investigations and remediations. Last, part of customers' tenants is a detonation chamber for deep file analysis. This is a sandbox where security teams can upload suspicious files and get a readable report back. This is an incredibly powerful, yet safe way to investigate potential threats. Security teams use the Microsoft Defender Security Center to access their Defender for Endpoint data and to interact with endpoints. They might investigate potential threats, respond to a breach, or improve their security postures. It's where the security analysis happens. The console provides dashboards, a variety of reports, and different views of individual entities. And security analysts can quickly pivot from one data point to another. On top of data visualization, it provides security teams a rich toolset for their incident investigations, like advanced hunting, live response, and many other response actions. The Microsoft Defender for Endpoint sensors gather security-related events from onboarded endpoints and send those events to customers' tenants. The only thing needed is an internet connection, so the service supports almost every conceivable scenario for company-owned devices. Security teams can also trigger endpoints to perform actions like collecting suspicious sample files, isolating from the network, or running a full AV scan. All Defender for Endpoint security controls on the endpoint generate valuable security events. These include threat and vulnerability management, next generation protection, attack surface reduction, the EDR sensors, and many more, as well as the update service. However, security teams must turn on and configure some of these controls before they start generating events. Customers can use that near real-time data for visibility, reporting, investigation, and threat hunting. Additionally, the service uses that sensor data for correlation, breach detection, visibility, security analytics, and signal exchange with other Microsoft Threat Protection services. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint is a key component of Microsoft 365 Defender, which combines other Microsoft security services like Microsoft Defender for Identity, Microsoft Defender for Office 365, and Microsoft Cloud App Security to provide an integrated experience. Additional integrations with Azure Sentinel, Azure Defender, Microsoft Information Protection, and Microsoft Endpoint Manager enables new scenarios for our customers. Aside from those, customers can also integrate Microsoft Defender for Endpoint with existing security infrastructures by using our rich set of APIs. For example, they can connect their SIM or ticketing systems to our service or enable their own custom security workflows. Customers can even add their own threat intelligence by using the API or the console itself. Key architectural components of Defender for Endpoint are the Security Center console, endpoint sensors, and customers' isolated and secure Microsoft Defender for Endpoint tenants. To learn more about the service's architecture, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.